Good morning, I'm Professor Dr. Mike Chan from a European Wellness Group. You know, and everyone is talking so much about the stem cells, magical buzzword. Each time there's a stem cell cream, there's a stem cell shampoo, everyone would think, oh, it's so special, I will buy the stem cell cream and shampoo. But most of the time, it may not be what it seems to be. There's no stem cell shampoo, there's no stem cell cream. Okay, because basically a cell will only survive for 72 hours in the petri dish. So you want to keep the cells alive means you must have water, oxygen, and some nutrients for the cell to feed on. Okay, so that is stem cells. But again, we have to understand in the human body, you have 37.2 trillions of live cells in the body. As you are born, you have all these cells out of the 220 organs and tissue. So there are hundreds of cells in the organs and tissue because, for example, in the brain, you have 67 different types of brain cells from the 52 brain lobes. In the liver, you have 75 different types of cells. So if you want to treat liver disease, you probably need a hepatocyte. Again, in the pancreas, you have 13 different types of cells in the pancreas. Again, you need the islets of the pancreas to treat diabetes type 2 specifically and to give the best result. So now, talk about stem cells. With the 37.2 trillion of live cells in your body, there's only one stem cell of 10,000 live cells when you're born up to 2 years old. And you're aging at a very fast speed because by the age of 60, you only have 5% left of your stem cell in your body. That is around 800 to 1 million live cells and you only find one stem cell there. By the age of 18, when we are just approach our teenager age, you know, you'll be surprised you're left with only around 45% left of stem cells in the body. And by the age of 30, you only have 25% left. So just imagine how much we are aging. Again, everyone is saying that, oh, we have these stem cells. Stem cells can cure all kinds of disease. It's not true. Stem cells can turn into different types of cells in the body. Again, it's not true. There's a lot of difference between cells and stem cells, okay? Imagine the cells have the bees. The stem cells will be the queen bees. Okay, so which one is better? Of course, the queen bees is better because the queen bees have all the nutrients for the rest of the bees and the queen bee will live longer. So what will be the best stem cells? We all know that there are so many different types of stem cells. You heard of embryonic stem cells, okay? And why don't we use embryonic stem cells which are pluripotent? The problem with pluripotentness is that it will also turn into cancer cells because cancer cells is also pluripotent cells. So that was the reason that embryonic stem cells, apart from the ethical issues, we don't use embryonic stem cells, okay? Now, next, we also talked about multipotent. Now, what is multipotent? That means there are cells coming from the tissue. And cells like this will be example from the umbilical cord blood. You have the hematopoietic cells, you have the mesenchymal cells, which are from umbilical cord blood. Of course, you can still take from the peripheral blood. You can take from the bone marrow. You can even take from the adipose, from the fats. And this is what many of the physicians today are doing all over the world. They will come up with different names. They can call it SVF. You can call it mesenchymal cells. They can call it some other things. Now, again, please understand. Remember I was telling you, the cells will be as old as your biological age and never as your chronic sugar age. One. Now, the same goes for the stem cells because the organ is aging, as we know. Every organ in our body, you know, are aging. The brain is fully developed by the age of 26 in the frontal lobe, but other parts of the brain are actually deteriorating at the age of 20. Our muscles is going down at 30. Our fertility of a male and female is going down at 35. Our eyes is deteriorating at 40. So there's so many things you understand. The lungs, the gut are all going down at 55. The liver is a stronger one. It's aging at around 70. So with each different organs and different lifestyles of everyone, so the lifespan of every organs will have an effect and have a chain reaction into all our system in our body. So that's where our disease will set in and we are more prone to having diseases is because we're having lesser stem cells as we age. So if I'm telling myself, I'm telling you that I'm 59 years old, which is what I am today, okay? That means to say my cells could be 59 years old or it can also be even older than 59 years old. So it depends on how we maintain ourselves, okay? Now, if you were to use organ-specific cells, the next cells coming in, okay? Apart from what I was saying, that the multipotent cells, they are the tissue cells, mesenchymal cells, for example, may turn, the word is may, or it may not turn to, into tissue cells. And those tissue cells will be all the different types of the cartilage, the joints, the ligaments, but they may or they may not turn to successfully. Please understand that. So sometimes they don't turn well. Okay. Now, If you were to go further down from the multipotencies of cells, you will go down, there's another category of cells, we call it the unipotent cells. And these are the precursors and progenitor cells. These are the cells which are undifferentiated cells in the final stage of differentiation. So this is very important, you know, because you are going into very specific cells to treat specific disease. If you have an eye problem, I probably give you the retina cells, I probably give you the optic nerve, I probably give you the occipital lobe because the brain would not see. So you need occipital lobe for the brain to react, you know. It's no point to have the eyes to see, but the brain don't see. Now, the same things you have to understand, the most important organ in the body is probably the brain. The brain is controlling all the functions and all the movements, you know. So we must have a young brain all the time. That is one of the ways to keep ourselves very young. I always believe you must have good brains, okay? So you must take care of your brain. Now, how do we take care of brain? We all know that we will have Alzheimer's some point in time in our life. Parkinson is coming in for many of us some point in life. That means your brain is aging. Remember, I'm saying that you're aging at 20 years old where the brain starts to age, although the frontal lobe is fully developed by the age of only 26. Now, with different parts of the brain, they also age differently, okay? So this is how we will go into specificity. That means to say that if we have to treat Parkinson patient, we probably have to give the substantia nigra. You know, we probably have to give the hippocampus to control the movements. Again, for autism, you probably also have to give different types of brain cells, again for Down syndrome, again for different disease. Again, for diabetes type 2, you probably need to give the islets of the Langerhans coming from the pancreas. Again, diabetes may have some liver problems, they may have some gut problems, they may have some kidney problem, and the end stage is a kidney transplant, so you probably have to give the renal cells too. What about heart? In the case of the heart, you know it's not very regenerative. Again, it's good to give the cardiomyocyte. So the word stem cells itself doesn't mean that stem cells will cure everything. It depends on what type of stem cells you're using.